Rarely in the world of music, all the members of the same family achieve so much success. Andy Gibb reached the pinnacle of fame at a very young age. The Bee Gees were the most important in the disco era. Today, I bring you the life of the Gibb Brothers. Douglas, Isle of Man, a dependency of the United Kingdom's crown. Barbara married Hugh Gibb, a prominent drummer of his time, which is why their children followed in his footsteps.
What do you used to do when you were kids? What do you used to play?
We used to play around in the ruins of houses that were bombed during the war and things like that. There was a lot of ruins in those days.
We made them.
By the 1960s, the Bee Gees were performing on television shows. Barry quickly caught the attention of Australian star Cole Joy due to his songwriting ability, and Joy helped the young men secure a recording deal with Festival Records in 1963 under the name Bee Gees.
When you were growing up, what kind of stuff did you listen to?
Oh, we listened to Motown, Beatles. I think everybody was influenced by them then. But mostly it was black R&B music, Motown music.
But I think a lot of the music today is derivative of the 50s, 60s, and 70s anyway. Yeah. And it's sort of all clubbed into the one kind of sound. And it's very...
So it's like the disco today is a sort of, I guess, a Stock, Aitken & Waterman type records that are repetitive sequences with a straight down bass drum, which is disco today. You know, so it's, to us, we were never disco. We were into R&B, like How Deep Is Your Love is R&B. It was never...
Oh, let's go with dance records. There'll always be dance records.
Oh, yeah.
Ta-da.
Yeah.
Let's go. I like it. Yeah.
In late 1966, the family decided to return to England to try their luck with music there. In 1967, during an audition with Robert Stigwood, who would become their manager from then on, the Bee Gees signed a 5-year contract. Stigwood proclaimed the Bee Gees to be the most significant talent of 1967, and comparisons to the Beatles began immediately. However, the Bee Gees continued to chart with songs like Lonely Days from 1971, which reached number 3. In 1972, the Gees brothers reached number 16 with their song Run to Me from the LP To Whom It May Concern. This single marked the Bee Gees' return to the UK top 10 for the first time in 3 years.
Someone has hurt you and torn you apart.
And with this, How Can You Mend a Broken Heart? From the album Trafalgar, they achieved their first number one.
How can you mend this broken man? Please help me mend my broken heart.
In 1975, thanks to a suggestion from famous musician Eric Clapton, the brothers moved to Miami, Florida. By the end of the 1970s, 3 Bee Gees singles reached number 1 in the United States and in most countries around the world, resulting in the most popular period of the disco era. One of them was this, How Deep Is Your Love?
Know your eyes in the morning sun, and it's me you need to show. How deep is your love?
Another of their great songs, Stayin' Alive, was also hugely successful at the time. And who can forget this? Night Fever, which was also part of the film Saturday Night Fever, starring John Travolta. All these successes led the group to win the Grammy for Best Album in 1979.
Saturday Night Fever!
Thank you. Oh, incredible. Thank you very, very much. We'd like to thank our record company, RSO Records, our manager, Robert Stigwood, Al Curry, Bob Edson, Rich Fitzgerald, our band, Dennis Bryan, Alan Kendall, Lou Weaver, for bringing it home. Thank you. Thank you.
I did. I spent all night reading up on you. Saturday Night Fever was the biggest hit ever.
Well, it's the biggest selling soundtrack in history. Michael Jackson, of course, took the number one spot with the biggest selling album in history. Right. And so those songs weren't really written for Saturday Night Fever, they were simply written to be our next album. And four of those songs ended up being part of the soundtrack.
In the 1980s, the Bee Gees wrote super hit songs for artists like Barbara Streisand. This What Kind of Fool was one of the songs on the singer's albums composed of songs written by the three brothers.
There was a time when we were down and down.
Write for many other stars,
yeah, and
singers.
I also produce other artists too, yes.
This other song, Heartbreaker, was made for Dionne Warwick in 1982. Also, this other song, Chain Reaction, was one of the most successful songs for singer Diane Ross. Another of their super hits, Islands in the Stream, was a multi-million selling hit in the United States and number one on the charts.
Hold me closer and I feel no pain, every beat of my heart. Islands in the Stream, that is what we are, no one is giving me.
On the other hand, Andy became the first solo artist to have three consecutive number one singles on the Billboard Hot 100. With this song, I Just Want to Be Your Everything, written by his brother Barry, Andy achieved his greatest success.
So long, you and me been finding each other.
I want you laying in the love I have to bring.
This other song, Shadow Dancing, from 1978, reached number 7 on the charts.
All that I need is just one moment in your arms. I wish you were alive, taking me through the night, shadow dancing.
And this beautiful song, Rest Your Love on Me, performed as a duet with Australian Olivia Newton-John, was also a great success.
Baby, you don't know me any more than I know you. Rest your love on me.
Additionally, Andy occasionally performed with his brothers, which led to many instances where he considered joining them. There's no doubt they were a very happy family. They had it all, fame, money, success. Until one fateful day, March 10th, 1988, tragedy struck the family.
On March 7th, Andy became violently ill and suffered stabbing pains in his chest and abdomen. Paramedics rushed him to the local hospital. But the English doctors were unaware of the long-term damage that drugs and alcohol had done to Andy's heart. They never contacted his doctors in America.
I thought that the physicians in London would have been well served by talking.
It's the last time she would ever see her youngest son alive. The cause of death was listed as myocarditis, an inflammation of the tissue surrounding the heart. Even though the autopsy found no drugs or alcohol in Andy's system, the tabloids immediately called his death a cocaine overdose. But his family knew that drug abuse had killed Andy. It just took a decade to do it. The family coping with the cruelest kind of loss. Older brothers saying goodbye to the youngest. Parents burying a child. A lasting love.
I'm too young to die.
I still have a very difficult time discussing Andy with anybody, so it's just not, I can't bear my soul about it at this point.
It's still very
close to me and not that far away, you know, not that long ago.
After this, the Bee Gees continued their career, releasing the album One the following year in 1989.
Yeah, well, this album is once again much more R&B orientated for us, and it's a warmer album. And the nice thing about this album is that we went live. We did, it's a live band, you know? And when you hear a band like this, you know, it's amazing. And and that's what's missing from a lot of records, because people use a lot of programming these days.
Right.
And we've sort of been through that, and we hate it now. And we want to be live, and we want to be like Tracy Chapman, you know, where you actually perform.
Not
and
then people want.
With this song you're listening to, the G's reached number 7 on the U.S. Top 10. They also included this song dedicated to Andy, Wish You Were Here. The 1990s arrived, and the brothers continued to accumulate successes with songs like this one, performed on their European tour, reaching the top 5 with For Whom the Bell Tolls. And the song Alone, which also reached the top 5 in the UK and top 30 in North America. At the time, Barry began to suffer from a serious back problem that required surgery, but he wasn't the only one living in pain. Maurice battled a serious alcohol addiction for many years, which he eventually overcame with the help of Alcoholics Anonymous. However, around this time, the boy's father, Hugh Gibb, also passed away.
Which one is your relationship between you guys?
What's relationship? We're brothers.
Yeah. After 30 years playing music.
I think after 30 years of experiencing things good and bad together, you know, it's brought us closer together.
Entering the 2000s, in 2001, the Bee Gees released their last album as a group, This Is Where I Came In, which featured songs like Man in the Middle, written by Maurice. Robin wrote Deja Vu. Sweet Deja Vu. Through the beast of famine, I'll be with you. And Barry composed Voice in the Wilderness. It seemed that everything was going perfectly for the G's brothers again. For a moment, it was thought they would overcome the loss, but it wasn't to be. Without warning, the third family tragedy struck. On January 12, 2003, Maurice suddenly passed away. After this, Robin and Barry each worked separately, sometimes with other singers, such as in 2002 with Michael Jackson. What is my life if I don't believe there is someone? From time to time, the two brothers would reunite to sing at charity galas, like this one in 2009. But on May 20th, 2012, tragedy struck again. Robin died after a long battle with cancer. Too much for a single family. With Robin's death, the group's musical career came to an end. However, in September and October 2013, Barry Gibb, the only surviving brother, embarked on his first solo tour in the UK, called Mythology, even performing with his niece Samantha. the new generation of the family was already stepping onto the stage. After this, Barry was seen on television talking about his brothers. He couldn't hold back his tears. He was left alone, having lost all three. At one point, his mother said that their family had been cursed.
Don't cry alone.
But should we remember this family for so much tragedy? At the Changer Channel, we don't think so. We believe that the Bee Gees deserve to be remembered for all the successes they contributed to music. That is, for the beautiful songs they wrote throughout their career that reached millions of hearts worldwide. If you liked the video, give it a like, subscribe, share it with your friends, and please don't forget to activate the bell to be notified of new videos. This is Changer's Channel, thanking you for always being there.